Buenas tardes. ¿Dónde están los latinos? I couldn't hear that. ¿Dónde están los latinos? Estamos a punto de comenzar. Por favor, tomen asientos. Estamos a punto de comenzar. Please take your seats. We're about to start. And for those of you who speak English, where are the Latinos? All right. Marconi, ¿qué me dice? ¿Dónde está Marconi? ¡Hueva! Ok. Estamos listos. Bueno, good afternoon. Buenas tardes, Lieutenant Governor Kim Driscoll. And I would like to welcome our people to the people's house.
¡Sí se puede!
¡Sí se puede! ¡Sí se puede! ¡Sí! Hispanic Heritage Month celebration with the Healy Driscoll administration. Thank you to our council members that are here today, to the council generals, to the elected officials, and all the community leaders, CBOs, and Latino leaders that are here. Un aplauso bien grande. Que se escuche del primer piso al cuarto piso. Each year, Americans observe the National Hispanic and Latinx Heritage Month from September 15 to October 15. So you can imagine, we cannot sleep during that month. The parties are abundant. But by celebrating this, we're celebrating our histories, our cultures, our contributions as Americans, as citizens, as residents, as people. And we celebrate the cultures of Mexico, the Caribbean, Central America, South America, and we're here today to do that, to do those, you do just that, honor our contributions. But I cannot move ahead without first thanking Governor Healy. Why? Because in the 2 years so that she's been here, she has been accomplishing things for the Latino community, starting with the in-state tuition law that she signed right away into law. A successful implementation of the WFMA Act, the creation of Mass Connect, the school meals in our schools, Affordable Homes Act, come on! Language access across the state. And she continues to listen to us, and she continues to implement policies that are gonna leave Latinos in a better place. And for that, we love you. And we love you too, Kim Driscoll. We have lots of love. So with that said, I just want to pass it now to my friend here from Peru, Mariana Walker, who is going to be singing the national anthem. Mariana.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so perilous fight or the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in or the land of the and the home of the
lo que tiene que ver con comunidades inmigrantes, lo que tiene que ver con los latinos, lo que tiene que ver con todo este comité que escucha las voces del pueblo. Nosotros hacemos estas reuniones en diferentes regiones de Massachusetts, le traemos todas estas sugerencias a ella y eso es implementado, y eso es efectivo, y eso es el poder de esta administración. Muchísimas gracias. Thank you.
And earlier, we also want to thank our legislators because so many of the things that we were able to get done, the recommendations happen because we have an incredible legislature and incredible representation reflected here today. So we want to thank you. All those things that we brag about that got done, you know, those were laws, those were things that were passed that we had the privilege of signing. So I want to thank all of you. I want to acknowledge our leader, Frank Moran, who's with us today, our caucus vice chair, Andy Vargas. We also have Senator Gomez, Senator Pavel Payano, and we have Representative Manny Cruz, Rep. Garcia, Rep. Reyes, Rep. Senna. We have Rep. Arriaga, Rep. Medaros here, Rep. Fugger-Oakley, Rep. Garbley. I may have missed folks. Sarah Peek, in a new role, we'll shout him out. Auditor Diana DiZoglio is here. Thank you. So we just are grateful to so many of our colleagues across government. Thank you to this incredible community of leaders, of educators, of artists, of innovators. Thank you for the beautiful gift of song. That was wonderful. Thank you. Look, we're proud to have the most diverse cabinet in history, over 350 leaders of color on our boards and commissions. Thank you to this wonderful Latino Empowerment Advisory Council for everything that you have done. And we're stronger as a state because of it. You know, there's a reason that we're number one in education, in innovation, in healthcare. We've been voted the best place to have a baby and to raise a family, the best place to live if you're a woman. And we're just getting started. We know there is so much more work to be done to make sure that Massachusetts is more competitive, more affordable, and more equitable. And we look forward to continuing to work with all of you on this. This is really wonderful this month. We should celebrate Hispanic and Latino heritage every month of the year, of course. But it's nice.
Every Wednesday.
But it's nice to have been able to sign. We just got a chance to sign the proclamation. So keep up the great work. And what else did I miss?
Lots of work done, lots of work left to do. We've got a great team leading us in the State House. Timely reports and actions coming out as we get ready for the next fiscal year, the next policy setting year. So we've done great things, but wait till we really get started. We're not finished. With this team, we're going to get it done.
That's right. All right.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys. Gracias, un aplauso que se escuche. Let's get loud. Bueno, meninas y meninos, ¿a dónde están los brasileros?
Aquí.
Pues no faltaba más. No faltaba más, porque ahora vamos a escuchar de la música de Cynthia Capoeira, el Brazilian performance. ¿Listos? Meninos, meninas. Você está, eso está ótimo. Ótimo.
Maravilloso.
Okay, bueno, ahora we are going to present to the performers a citation. Governor Healy and Lieutenant Crisco, please come over here. We are going to present each of these wonderful performers today a citation, and I'm happy to read these names for you. Here we go. Vamos a comenzar con Felipe Ortiz. Felipe, un aplauso para Felipe por aquí. Felipe is a Colombian artist who creates a range of artworks from traditional Esso painting to murals and public installations. He founded the Fresco Exchange Group, invested in the creative and cultural exchange of for artists across the globe. Y ahora, Michelle Falcón Fontanet de Springfield. La Michelle. All right. Michelle illuminates on her stories, often female and Latina voices, through photography, film, theater, and public art. Y ahora, Mariana Walker. El aplauso. Ella fue la que cantó el himno. Un aplauso. She's been born and raised in San Diego, but deeply involved in local arts, especially chorus, and embracing every opportunity to share and celebrate her Peruvian heritage. Aplauso para ella. Y the High Square Task Force, the Afro-Latin Youth Singing Dance Group. ¿Dónde está mi gente de High Square Task Force? Vengan para acá. Woohoo! High Square Task Force support youth as they explore, master, and celebrate Afro-Latin culture by providing free year-round programming where youth receive training in dance, music, or theater. Also provide social, emotional, and educational support, mentoring and encouraging civic engagement. Gracias. Where are capoeira people, meninos y meninas? In the United States, by partnering with government, not-for-profit, and private organizations to organize events and competitions to increase knowledge about Afro-Brazilian culture and history. Aplauso. Thank you so much. Bueno, y vamos a seguir la fiesta, que aquí no nos vamos hasta la amanezca. We continue here until next morning. And to continue the party, I would like to ask the people from High Square Task Force and your beautiful performance to come over here and perform for us. High Square Task Force, understand? Yes, of course. Thank you. Together we're going to leave the Latino community in a better place. Muchas gracias a todos.